Teide, the highest mountain in Spain, 12,200 feet high. There's 50% less oxygen at the top than there is at sea level, and the temperature was minus 2 degrees centigrade. On Sunday, the 3rd of December, 13 of us, with a combined age of 856 years, the oldest being 81, climbed to the top of the peak. For the first 2 to 3 kilometres, the climb is pretty easy, but then it starts to get difficult.
We're nearly at the top. If we just turn around here, you'll see behind me, that's where we've got to get up. And it's only about, another 100 metres or so. And we're feeling great. If you just stop for a little rest, you're feeling really great and not doing too badly. The person you heard shouting down there is our esteemed leader, and that is Seamus. Let me see if I can zoom into him. There we are. No, I can't. But never mind. No, I can't. Oh, there we are. I can do it that way. And there he is, down there in the dark blue.
We'd be staying overnight at the refuge, which is 1,200 feet below the summit.
To stay in this refugio overnight, it's about a 6 weeks booking list in advance, so we had to get a night to suit everyone. So we tried from about the middle to end of October, and the 3rd of December was the first night we could get free, that we could all arrange to come here. Thank God it worked out okay. The weather was beautiful today. It was cold night, but beautiful. We're not up to the top yet, so...
Okay, so this is where we've been having here. This is the dining area. There you can see it back there and now. And through here, we go into the dormitory. And let me just sort of show you what's happening in here. Look at all that lot there. There's Sandra getting into bed. Just about settling down. It's what time is it now? 7:30. So... in a few hours' time, we're going to be up at 4:30 to depart at 5 o'clock.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
It's now about 5:30 in the morning, and we're setting off on the final push for the summit. We're hoping to get up there by 4:30 so that we'll be able to see the sunrise. It's not easy going because, as you can see down here, if I can point the camera in the right direction, it's all scree and it's dark, so we have to do everything very, very gently and carefully, otherwise you could fall over. Morning all.
Good morning, John.
Good morning, Seamus. Morning, Joe.
Good morning, John.
There we are as you go past. Morning.
What time is it? What time is the 4:38 leave here?
Good morning. Good morning. On we go. On we go. We're just about 100 metres from the top, which is up there, if you can see it. And it's hard going. It's very, very rocky. Look at down there. Really bad, really heavy rocks down here. I've lost Seamus. I don't know where he is. I've shouted for him, but I can't find him. Anyway, I'm here, and I think we're the only two that's come up. I don't know. But in a few moments' time,
the sun will be coming up. There's the moon. Now if I just turn it round like that, you see it over there. And down below me, the sulfur and steam rising out of the crater all the way around there. And if you put your hands in the rocks, it's hot. In fact, I nearly burnt myself on one occasion.
Eventually, I did find Seamus, and Norman, and David, and Margaret. Also Phil and Susie, who lent me a pair of gloves because my hands were frozen. The youngest, Kieran, aged 37, serenaded us all the way up with his ukulele. And of course, the oldest, Michael, aged 81. And this is what we came to see.
Here comes the sun, do do do. Here comes the sun, and I say, it's all right.
Brilliant.